Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I want to tell you that most people do not know the difference between Kingdom of Heaven and the Royal Kingdom of God. So, Heaven is concerned with what you see with two naked eyes, and the Royal Kingdom of God is concerned with your third eye of logical reasoning, the language which our Father understands and in which we render praises to Him. So here is the two kingdoms. This is Kingdom of Heaven that you see in law and order. And if you know Luke 16, verse 16, Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. That means transgression against the moral law is called sin. So sin disappears in this dark age. There are no more prophets after John the Baptist. Prophets are ideal moral teachers, and Jesus wasn't a prophet. Here's the difference between the prophet and the saint. There are the prophets. John the Baptist came here, and here are the saints. Least in the Royal Kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist. So the Royal Kingdom of God, this is the Kingdom of Heaven, whatever you see with two naked eye, and it is in law and order is established. When the people become crook, you know, the rabbis become crook, they can't dispense justice. And then this disappears. When Christ come, He introduced to us this one, the Royal Kingdom of God, which is in your heart, and it is on individual basis. So this kingdom belongs to Yahweh, and this kingdom belongs to our Elohim, Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Yahweh is called Brahma and Khuda in Arabic. So this belongs to Allah. Al-Illah, the tribal father, the spiritual father. And to understand this one, I made this t-shirt design which clarifies that our supernatural father is called Allah, or Elohim, or Parbrahm. Now the diminutive of Allah, Parbrahm, and Elohim is these angels, John the Baptist, who was a witness to the light but not the light. So unless you are born of water, here is the born of water. He baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. He never baptized a woman, a Gentile, or a Samaritan, only the Jewish men. So this is the baptism of water which John the Baptist gave. He said, I am baptizing in water, the one coming after me will baptize your Holy Spirit. Today you see in the churches, they are baptizing women, children, everything, you know. And they do so in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, which is wrong. It is written there in the same parable where he was baptizing in River Jordan. Now, don't you say that you are sons of Abraham? I can turn stones into sons of Abraham. Now, most of these people, which are European especially, dead in letters, they don't understand what stone means. Stone does not mean pebble lying on the ground. Stone means once born, simple-minded person, as Peter was. He didn't understand gospel, except at Pentecost when he received the very Spirit of God, then he was the first one who was preaching gospel. Otherwise he was quiet, you know. So, the royal kingdom of God is only you get it when you are born of water. That means you have got the spirit. You are not dead people, you are twice born. Because in the temple they were making them view outwardly. When you become view outwardly, then you break your covenant with Abraham. So those who understood this one, that you have to build your covenant with Abraham on tribal basis, not on religious basis. They were sensible and they were twice born. They came to John the Baptist for baptism. Whereas the stooges of the temple, once born, they did not bother. They were view outwardly. And John the Baptist was making them view inwardly, spiritual self. And here is the relationship between Adam. Here is Adam. Under Adam, you know, you get races. Under races, you get tribes and all that. Here is God, which is inside us, is invisible. So here come Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian. They are the spiritual self, not the physical self. Physical selves are Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, Jatt tribe, so many tribes we have. So not a single Jew died during Holocaust, or Hindu or Sikh or Muslim during the riots. But the tribal people, they killed each other. So this is the to make you sure that you are son of Adam, born of water, that you don't become Jew, Hindu, Sikh outwardly of appearance or of the physical self. And those who realized this one, and they came to John the Baptist, they were twice born, but they were doing their jobs. Some was farming, some were doing this and that. So they had the Holy Spirit, and John was instructed, the one on which the Holy Spirit rests, he is the one. And when Christ Jesus came for baptism, and when he was baptized, then on him the Holy Spirit rested, and then he told that this is the one, which is the anointed one, and he is going to lead you. He is the shepherd for you. So those shepherdless people, then they join hands with Jesus. And there you are, they to join hands with Jesus, you have to pass through this narrow gate, which is for solitary. So these people are solitary. This is the royal kingdom of God. Royal kingdom of God, because this true wine was planted by our Father, Supernatural Father Christ, Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. He planted this true wine, and we have to suck our, we have to transform our seed into plant and then enter this narrow gate to reach Him and turn our seed into plant, and we have to graft ourselves to this true vine to suck the flesh of Jesus, and then to, through intuition or logical reasoning, we turn that food into gospel treasures. And when it has been turned into gospel treasures, then you go around and preach gospel, which is called drinking the blood of Christ. So the person who gets this knowledge is on an individual basis. Not a group of people can get it. So on an individual basis you have to get it, you have to be capable of intuition. If you are capable of intuition, then you will get the gospel treasures. Otherwise you will be just talking rubbish or seeking your own praises as the psychic do. You have to be nomadic, solitary, not in a group, solitary. And then you enter this royal vineyard of our supernatural father, and the people who enter, they are called saint. And they are individualistic because the grace of our supernatural father comes to you, and so you will be able to then understand and preach gospel. So this is the royal vineyard of our father, where the solitary enter, whether they are male or female, doesn't matter, because soul has no gender like we have in our body. So they come here and enjoy the bliss of our supernatural father when they do the will of our supernatural father, which Christ Jesus came to preach in the open. And he also was so proficient in the moral laws that he explained to the university theologian there what are the basis of the moral law when he was 12 years old. And then, so this is the royal kingdom of God, and is the one which we have to strive to enter through this narrow gate. And the language which is spoken over there, and as in England or in Britain, the language spoken is English. And in different countries you have different languages, France, French. So here is the universal language which we speak, that is called logo, which is end product of logical reasoning. So if you are capable of logical reasoning, then you are the son of the Most High. You are twice born. If you are not capable of logical reasoning, then you are once born. Born and die like animals. So this royal kingdom of God, in that one freely you receive, freely you give. Because over there when you learn things, you don't, the gospel can be written down in ink on paper. Because gospel is done, received through logical reasoning, which is called logo. And logo is his word or gospel. So that only you get it when you are capable of logical reasoning. So I will leave it here. I hope I discussed it beyond the, into the royal kingdom of God. You enter solely, you enter individually. A group cannot enter through that one. The people which run religious sites and other thing, you will find them, they are advertising and all that, you know, they are asking for money, donations. And remember that when the first Church of God was founded, people sold their possessions to buy that field. So in a priest, dog collar priest, they go to university to learn scripture, which are the dead letters. And they are free to work on salary or other basis to make money out of that one. So the royal kingdom up here, and the language that you use here is called logical reasoning or Gur Prasad. Gur means formula to understand gospel. Formula is logical reasoning. That end product is logo. So unless you are capable of logical reasoning, you cannot have gospel. So our Father God blesses you, everyone. So you need to have it, and that's what I've written. No Christ in your heart, no gospel. So dead letters in the universities and other places, they do not have this knowledge. You will get it when you become individual. And so you have like Sadhu Melchizedek. Sadhu Melchizedek, he sold his possession to buy that field. Same way many people are devoted, even today they are devoted. They give their possession to buy a field. So our Father God blesses you, and hope it's an oral thing, you know, and I hope you understand it. Thank you.